Heroes of Overwatch, this is Patrick V and welcome to a new video. And in this video I'm gonna give you guys beginner's tips for Soldier 76. Here we go.
Traveling to Horizon Luna Colony.
Before we're gonna begin, be sure to smash that subscribe button, guys, because this channel is all about competitive Overwatch gameplay with or against subscribers. And if you want to be a part of that, be sure to smash that subscribe button and let me know in the comments below. So this is also the beginning of a new series. It's gonna call the 101 series, and basically what I will do is gonna give you guys some beginner's tips for heroes, and we're gonna start off with Soldier 76. It's not for no good reason that Soldier 76 is the first character introduced to in Overwatch's tutorial, and this particular hero represents the most immediately familiar shooter archetype amongst the imaginative collection of heroes in the game. He packs a rapid-fire weapon with grenade-like sight functionality and a sprint ability to get in and out of danger nice and quickly. So far, so familiar, you might think and you may not believe you need much of a guide to get the most out of this character. You shouldn't underestimate his potency on the battleground though. Just because he lacks some of the more outlandish design streaks found elsewhere in Overwatch's colorful roster of characters, as well as packing considerable firepower, he also enjoys the option to self-heal, and this bonus effect even extends to his buddies if they're nearby. He struggles to flank quite as impressively as likes of Tracer and Reaper, but he is extremely versatile and rarely a bad choice of offense character. In this Soldier 76 guide, I got a lot of useful tips for you how to extract even more power out of all these abilities, along with some strategy tips that I think should ensure you always come out on top of the fight. I also got some useful advice for you on Soldier 76's counters and who he should be targeting to ensure a fight goes in his favor. Okay, so let's see his ability first. He has a heavy pulse of fire. That's basically the R2. I play on PlayStation, the PS4, so it's R2. There's nothing at all that's particularly complicated about Soldier 76's standard weapon. It's the kind of high-powered laser-firing pulse rifle that you've seen in many games before, and it's capable of rattling off as a rapid series of shots that do a good job of ripping through the character's the target's health pool. Even better, the magazine clip is pretty generous, all things considered, reducing reload downtime. The Helix rockets. When you really need to go for the kill hard, switch over to this weapon's Helix rockets. Alternative fire by hitting the left trigger. Sorry, left trigger, the L2, and then fire a big old pile of rockets into your opponent's face. You also get a good bit of splash damage when you fire at multiple targets too, and it's a good way of taking out high HP units like turrets and tanks from range. The shift, that's L1 if I'm correct, holding down the shift button allows Soldier 76 to gain a temporary burst of additional speed. Not only is this boost great for catching up with the rest of the team after you respawn, it can also help you make a break for safety if you come under the kind of fire you really can't handle all by yourself. The cooldown ability is pretty short too, so make sure you've got eyes on its availability at all time and make free use of it. And Biotic Shield, along with his impressive burst damage, Soldier 76 also brings a little utility to teamfights in the form of his Biotic Shield ability. Drop one of these fellas onto the floor and you'll not only provide yourself with a heal over time boost, a particular advantage in duels, and you also provide the same benefit to any friend friendly heroes who are close proximity to its radiating effect. And then his ultimate, Soldier 76's ultimate ability is Tactical Visor. And in effect, an ultra accurate aim assist that makes it extremely easy to flick between targets and polish them off in quick succession. Simply wait for your targets to fall within the expanded reticule and then fire. Note that this ability autofocus on the chest area of enemies, preventing you from pulling off more critical headshots. Just something to keep in mind. So let's see some really useful tips right now. Sprint is an extremely versatile ability. Use it to get back to the fight quickly, dart forward and scope danger for your team. Flank the enemy or just get out of the dodge when it all goes disastrously wrong. Sorry guys. Note that the longer you hold down fire on your pulse rifle, the more inaccurate your aim becomes. For this reason, it can be more effective to fire this weapon off in tight controlled bursts, particularly against distant enemies. Soldier 76's ultimate is a powerful thing indeed, and best used to focus on the squishiest characters in front of you if you want to get the most out of it, each time. The Helix Rocket's cooldown is a mere 8 seconds, so do get into the habit of working them into your standard combat mentality. They're particularly powerful when it comes to gaining an edge in a one-on-one duel, and they can absolutely annihilate squishier heroes. Try to tuck yourself away somewhere before activating the Biotic Field. On objectives, we like to get in a corner of a room that lies between you and the enemy. Get yourself in there nice and snug and then heal up. Keep in mind that Biotic Field radiates out of a device. That means you can place it on a moving objective like the payload and have it travel with the team. Tactical Visor immediately reloads your ammunition to its maximum capacity, so try to rattle off anything you have left in the tank before activating this incredible skill. While your sprint ability is very useful, if you fire your weapon or reload your weapon, you will have to reactivate it to maintain speed. The direct damage of Helix Rockets won't land against the Genji who's activated deflect, but the splash damage will. Aim them at the ground by your target to gain this effect. You can only hit one target at a time while Tactical Visor is activated, so make sure you focus your attention on the squishiest targets and get the crosshair as close to them as possible. You still need to aim while your ultimate is activated. So these were the tips that I have for you so far. And if you really like these tips, if you want me to make more videos like this, let me know in the comments below. If you want me to do more about Soldier, for example, the counters, what characters he's strong against, some tips for some maps, I mean, that's possible as well, of course. Let me know in the comments below and I will see if I can do that. So thanks everyone for watching, bye bye!